Can I ask you why you got on a club bracelet in the middle of the day? That's all I want to know.
I was on that, but I wasn't going to say it. I'm like, what's she been on already? You know what?
I'm Monique Jordan.
I'm Jade Nicole.
Amanda.
Brittany.
I'm Ms. Mardell.
And this is Women Talk Wednesday. Each and every Wednesday, we talk about a topic that women are most interested in. Men are too, but they don't say they are, but we do know y'all be watching too. Anyway, this week we're going to talk about the code. All right, so here's the scenario. You're in a relationship, right? Okay, so say I'm in a relationship with my dude, and my dude's cousin, best friend, uncle, father, come talk to me. What do I do? Do I tell him or do I handle it myself? So I wanted to bring it to the ladies and see what they thought about it. Jay?
Well, you already know my stance. I feel like, first of all, I'm going to address it because in order for a man to approach me knowing that I'm with his friend or his cousin or whatever, then that means he doesn't respect me. He thinks that I'm whatever type of woman. So I'm going to address him right then, you know, and it's not going to be nice. Okay. But then after that, I will be, you know, telling my guy, hey, listen, this happened. I want you to know, just in case he comes and tells you, you know, that we had words, this is what it was about, you know, so.
Okay.
Going that way.
What about you, Shorty?
I agree with that.
I was going to say, I actually agree with that completely.
Yeah, because we're going to have words, and I don't want it to get, you know, taken out of context by the time it gets back to him on
right.
What really went down.
Right.
So, knowing me, I'll call him right there, like, oh, okay, hold on one second, and have him on speakerphone, like,
okay.
Now what were you saying?
Okay.
But
so,
that's me.
So, do anybody have the issue with maybe he don't believe you, he'd believe his family member before he believes you, or how would you work that?
I have seen that before.
Yeah, absolutely.
Where, you know, there was a family member that was approached by somebody's significant other, and the family member actually, you know, went mad and was like, no, you're not going to come in here trying to take my man. I know you're just trying to break us up. And it was really stupid.
And didn't believe it at all. And the whole time, he was really trying to get with the other person.
Yeah.
And that's a hard situation to be in. You know what I'm saying? I think it depends on the relationship, how y'all trust each other and know one another. You know what I'm saying? Because for me, now, if my cousin, aunt, whatever, tried to hit on my boyfriend, I would want to know.
Right.
He needs to come tell me so I can handle that. Yeah, you might be able to handle it, but baby, I'ma handle that. My thing is, I don't want to be in the dark and they come over and they know something that I don't and I'm sitting there looking stupid.
Right.
I got an issue. So when I do find out, all hell is probably going to break loose. That's me though.
Y'all, because you hid it from me.
Exactly.
Right.
You hid it from me and you my best friend or my cousin or my sister or whatever. Mm-hmm. So we have issues.
Yeah.
You know, Madea, what you think?
Well, I don't even care y'all this, him. Your man going to do that. But he gonna be the weakest link.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And plus, you don't bring your man around your family no how.
Not family. Not family. Look, don't bring him around nobody.
No.
I mean, you know how they are.
Yeah.
You know
your man.
You know your man.
You know your man.
If your man gonna be that weak, you don't need him.
Right.
Goodbye.
Right.
I agree.
All right, so. This is a quick one because we all agree.
Yeah.
So
for once.
Yeah, right. So that means that y'all will, but see, I'm not going to handle it. I'm going to go straight to my man and be like, hey, you need to check him because he did so-and-so. So I wouldn't approach it. I'd be like, all right, cool. And I go to my man and be like, you better handle that. You need to handle that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because that's his people. That's his best friend. That's his cousin, whatever. Handle that.
Okay.
So I would love to know. That's
I don't think I can hold out. I'm gonna right then look no, and then hey now you can handle what I left. You know, but yeah.
You come take round two.
Right.
Okay. It was a KO in round one.
Right.
So you come on through and say
okay.
Your
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Y'all are too easy going because you need to put the foot down.
Baby, ain't nothing easy going about me. See, I tries to be calm and you know. My boyfriend and I are two different people. I'm very rah-rah, and he's like, well, let's think about this and this and that. And I'm like, think about, but I would let him handle it because I don't want to go off. You know, I go off enough. So I've been trying, you know, let it go and handle it. But if he don't handle it, then I'm going to handle it.
Right.
You know, so that's how that goes, period. But anyway, that's Women Talk Wednesday this week. So, happy 4th of July, everybody. Y'all have a safe weekend. Please, no drinking and driving. And if you are going to drink, get a Lyft. Yeah. All right?
Uber.
Y'all ain't right. Okay, this is not a club bracelet. It's,
oh,
it's a hospital.
From the hospital.
Band.
Okay.
My grandbaby's
all
in the hospital.
I thought it was the green.
Okay, that makes
y'all
me feel
so
better.
Mean.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Why
happy
always go there?
Usually white. I'm looking at green. Like,
I didn't see the right on that. All I saw was
right.
The green.
Y'all crazy. Big shout out to Children's Hospital in Birmingham for taking care of my grandbaby. All right?
Yes.
All right, so that's Women Talk Wednesday. Y'all be easy until next week. We out. Peace.